So, you want to bag your Honda City GM6. Hello and welcome to another video. I hope our new studio is not echoing that much. And welcome, yes, we are in our Makati shop. And yes, this is one of the first or the first car to be shot or to be filmed on our new shop. Ngayon, welcome. We are here. We're going to discuss about the Honda City GM6. As you can see, this is a previous client's car. Nagawa na natin ito before. It's back here for maintenance and might as well, sabi ko, shoot natin. So you want to bag your GM6 kasi wala pa. Right out of the bat, this will be very similar to the So you want to bag your Honda Jazz GK. Yes, the Jazz and the City share a very similar platform. So, for the sake of formalities, it's still a different model. Iba rin yung layout sa likod. So, kahit pareha sila ng suspensions ng Jazz, we will still discuss the Honda City. The Honda City is not a very difficult car to build and probably one of the most iconic cars to be bagged as well. Or, they are very multi-platform. A City can be static, bagged, racing, very, very versatile. But we're not going to talk about that. We're going to talk about the under chassis. And pag-usapan natin yung mga final thoughts natin later on once we discuss the under chassis of this car. Okay? So, it's going to get technical and educational. So, this is a perfect time to ask you to like, subscribe, and share this video. Okay? So, we are at 11,000 subscribers. Thank you nga pala sa inyo. So, anyway, let's discuss the under chassis. Hello and welcome sa unahan ng Honda City GM6 where we are actually greeted with a coilover conversion done by the shop. Ilan taon na to, pre?
Mag-go 1 year.
1 year.
This is a 1-year-old air suspension build ngayong October na to. As usual, sa mga frequent viewers natin, if wala tayong problema sa rubbing, wala naman tayong magiging problema sa wear and tear. The airbags can last as long as 5 years. Okay? If we are clear on the rubbing, this has air, okay? And it's clear of all obstacles na walang magpa-puncture sa kanya, okay? So, it will last. So, this is actually a Tane coilover, Tane Flex Z coilover converted to air suspension back last year. So, as you can see, we've been doing these coilover conversions for all types of brands and literally virtually any coilovers that you want, we can convert to air suspensions. So as you can see, very distinctive green color ng Tane. What's good about Tane is that it actually has a good damping rate, very adjustable and firm. I like it. Tane is actually my coilover choice. If I will buy a coilover out of the box na gusto kong air sus, it will be my best choice. We are actually greeted with a McPherson type suspension. Ibig sabihin na McPherson is, it actually pivots its shock on an axis, or in Tagalog, pumipihit yung shocks dun sa taas ng shock mount. Umiikot yung shocks niya. And that in turns will be a problem for air suspension kasi yung hose line umiikot din. So that's something na kailangan nyo tandaan if you're doing an air suspension build. As you can see, nagtutwist itong stab link and then nagpapakita yung ating hose line. As you can see, papakita yung hose doon. So that's something you need to know. McPherson strut. So GM6 naman is very familiar, very similar to the GK, Jazz GK na ginawa namin. So wala kang magiging masyadong problema and maluwag siya. Very straightforward suspension. Is it hard? If you can't do the coilover conversion, it will be very easy. But if you can't do the coilover conversion, then this is something na medyo mahirap gawin. So welcome sa likod ng suspension ng ating GM6, Honda City GM6. Going back to the topic of the air suspension, our airbag is actually sitting here at the back. As you can see, right out of the bat, it's actually a divorce suspension. So pag divorce suspension, from the word itself, magkahiwalay ang ating shocks at saka spring. Okay? The coil spring used to go here before. Ngayon, andito sa likod. So anong problema natin sa divorce? Divorce spring can't be done plug and play. Virtually, ito yung pinakamahirap na pwede natin gawin sa air suspension. If naka-divorced ka, most likely it will be sent to the shop to be aligned and centered out. Kasi ito yung iniiwasan natin. There's a bit of space here na kailangan mong iwasan. Alright, so I adjusted the view for you a bit para makita nyo sinasabi ko mga kailangang iwasan, kaya dapat sinesentro. Sa part na ito, medyo may malapit tayo sa subframe, so you really have to worry about not hitting these parts of the suspension. So as well as sa may shocks, dito sa may part ng may brake line, basta masentro mo to, or it's not really centro ang tawag, we actually offset it a bit. You know, offset namin, nilalayo namin dito yung bag, we're pushing it that way. Okay, that way, going towards the center of the car, we offset it a bit. Makikita mo yan dito sa plate flange dito. So, offsetting it and going away from the parts na pwede siyang mag-rub, yun yung mga key feature na kailangan mong gawin for a divorce setup sa likod. And technically, virtually any car follows the same setup and there's no escaping from it. Another thing to note is that kailangan mo mag-lock ng bags mo sa taas at sa baba so that when you do a three-wheel, hindi madi-dislodge to. It's been argued for a long time pero I still want to lock my bags. It's up to you. Bahala ka. If you're worried about uncrimping the bags, then you're buying shit bags. Sorry. Yun talaga ang katotohanan. So anyway, that's going to be it for the rear side. Divorce suspension, Tain coilovers, okay? All of that good stuff. Very simple. The rear side is not that easy to do on maybe on a medium scale. Not that hard, not that easy. Just right. Your builder should still be worried about this part. It's always the weak point. Yung weak point ng mga air suspension build ay pag-divorce ng suspension. Diyan lagi nagkakaproblema. And diyan dapat tayo bumabawi. Okay, hello and welcome sa rear side ng Honda City GM6. 50% ng trunk space niya is actually occupied. Okay, as you can see, the client opted to show the air suspension system than hide it underneath. Bakit? Kasi syempre, presentation. So, that being said, he is sporting a fitment AMS with a dual pump package. Okay? Pressure sensors lang to. Wala siyang height sensors. So, we have a 3-gallon tank at the back, as you can see. We have two Vier X444 pumps or 444C. 444C's ang tawag namin. Okay? They are mounted on a exomount. Okay? Exomount is the bracket behind that pump, as you can see. These are aluminum brackets na nakayakap sa tangke. This is what we call the exomount. It is used to clamp the system on the tank. Para saan? Para mawala ng vibration or mabawasan yung vibrational noise. Kasi yung vibration yung maingay na nagpo-propagate dun sa loob. Besides the vibrational noise elimination ng exomount, ng feature ng exomount, it actually presents the product in a clean way. The pumps are floating, nakatago ang mga wires dun sa ilalim ng mga bracket. So, malinis. Very clean, di ba? I actually like it. So, this is the package na ino-offer namin together with the endo mount, endo tank rather, na nasa loob yan lahat. Pero this is the exo version of it, nasa labas silang lahat. Presented nicely. He is sporting a first generation fitment management system. So makikita mo, malaki pang square yung aming logo. Box lang naman yung nabago, case lang naman yung nabago dun sa latest model. And mas maganda yung faceplate nila. Alright, that being said, tapos na tayo dito. Let's go on to the outro, final thoughts about the GM6. Welcome back! It's our final thoughts about the GM6. We are now here with the GM6. Ano ang kailangan natin sabihin sa GM6? Okay? As you can see, this specific GM6 is rocking some Workseeker CX. Okay? I-discuss natin yung wheel spec later na advised ko. Then, i-discuss natin yung wheel spec nito, kotseng to. If you want to have a bit of camber sa likod. Okay? So, that being said, pakita muna natin yung ating vehicle dynamics as usual. Tradisyon na natin dito. So, we're going to race the car. And yes, on the under chassis, we actually discussed na naka Tain coilovers to. Shoutout nga pala sa Tain. One of the best riding coilovers that I actually converted. So, ito yung maximum air up ni Brian. Brian is the owner. And then when we drop it, konti pa. Alright. So as you can see, malaking travel, mababang drop, it's a good stance platform as well. The Honda City is sporting a McPherson strut sa unahan, as we discussed. Not that difficult, but it is a annoying kind of suspension. Sa likod naman, divorced. If we're not going to do your air suspension, you better show this to your builder. Kasi kahit sabihin na natin, madali itong gawing kotse, madaling magkamali rin dito. Okay? So, madaling gawin yung kotse, pero madali rin magkamali. Sa sobrang dali ng kotse, baka mamaya, who knows, baka mamaya hindi nila ma-check. So anyway, wheel spec, okay? As a stance, o syempre, pag mag-air sus ka, nasa isip mo na yung stance eh. Para sa akin, if you're going to do a conservative wheel spec recommendation, ang i-recommend ko is 17 by 7.5 offset 42 or 40. Medyo malapit na yon dito sa fender. Pero okay pa yun, wala pang roll, wala pang ano. Okay yon. Okay? Bakit 17s? Kasi syempre, when you're doing air suspension, you want to look good as well. Ngayon, for Brian's setup, for his work seeker, kailangan mo na mag-camber pag ganito. Saan yung camber? Sa unahan, may konting camber na yan. Sa likuran, matindi ang camber niya sa likod. So if you really wanna pull off a stance look, okay, ang setup niya is 17 by 8 sa unahan, offset 40, 17 by 8.5, offset 37, sa likod. And naglagay kami ng camber. Hindi ko tanda kung gano'ng kadami yung nilagay namin camber. Negative 7 ba tayo? Okay, negative 7 sa likod. The way to do a camber sa mga city na to ay nilalagay ng shims. That's another video to talk about. Maybe we can do a video about shimming the rear axle ng mga economical cars na ganito para mag-camber. And is it safe or is it advisable? Saka na yon. For now, this is what we have. Okay? So if you want to do a stance boy look, eto siya. Pero yung recommendation ko is actually quite well. Now, para sa goma, subjective, I realize subjective ang goma. It's up to you. This is actually one of our most iconic cars here in Fitment dahil sa stance ng tindig ng auto niya at yung mugs na kinabit niya dito at yung linis. Okay? This was not his first transformation. This is probably the second transformation ng kotse. Iba pa ang mugs nung ginawa namin to. Pero I can say this is actually really good. It's a Honda City, a good platform for stance. Yes, sabi ko nga sa intro kanina, it's a very versatile platform. Pwede ka mag-stance, static, walang camber na stance, racing look, madami kang pwedeng gawin. Pwede mo nga babuyin pa eh, di ba? So, that being said, I recommend the Honda City as I've owned one myself. Okay? I hope you understood what we wanted to tell you on this video. If you are a GM6 owner, ano ba bang iniintay nyo? Andiyan na lahat. Okay? Wala na kaming tinago. Pinakita na namin sa inyo lahat para kampante-kampante na kayo. Alright? And that's going to be it for the GM6. So you want to bag your Honda City GM6. This is how. Shoutout nga pala sa landlord natin for this amazing, amazing, amazing showroom and workshop. Okay? If I say so myself. And congratulations sa ating lahat. Part of Fitment, sa mga nanonood nito, you're part of Fitment as well. Congrats muna natin. Slow clap muna tayo para sa team natin, sa mga viewers natin for supporting. And I really appreciate the support that you are all giving us. So that's going to be it for this video. It's been Cal from Fitment Engineering and you're watching Fitment TV. So you want to bag your car. So you want to bag your Honda City GM6. This is how. This is how we do it. Okay? See you on the next episode. Bye! Kitang-kita ba?